is 413-4104. 2199-2691. Or the creation of Department of Housing and Urban Development and House Bill Number 44 Act declaring the portions of the Westwood property as alienable and disposable. At first, I'd like to the chairman to ask the committee secretary to acknowledge the first person present today.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. We would like to acknowledge our distinguished resource persons. We'll start with the department, on the bill of the department, the creation of the Department of Housing. From HLRB, we have Attorney Antonio Bernardo and Commissioner Luis Paredes. From NHA, we have Attorney Sinfrosa Pagansan. Of course, from HATC, our Chair, Attorney Chito Cruz. From Shara, Attorney Beth Lampas. OSCAP, Attorney Jolene Pangulan. From GFIS, Attorney Michelle Yu Jr. and Mr. Oliver Flores. From Commission on Civil Service, Attorney Pilimar Escudero. From the Department of Finance, Ms. Joanna Castillo. From the Department of Budget and Management, Ms. Emelita Bailon. From the Public Fund, Attorney Deborah Capilli. NERA, Mr. Ramon Falcon. SSS, Ms. Marie Agape Silva. From National Home Mortgage Finance Corporation, Attorney Siegfried Lapasaran. With regard to our bill on the welfare bill, we have Honorable Mayor Abalos, Benjamin C. Abalos Jr. We have our representatives from Barangay Addition Hills, Mandaluyong, Mr. Rodolfo M. Rosales, Barangay Captain, and Mr. Pedrito Padrigon from the Welfare Bureau People's Assembly. Good afternoon. Mr. Chair.
Okay, thank you, Madam Secretary. We have two bills to look at this afternoon, and since the DMP or the bill on the Department of Housing was already taken up, if it's okay to our guest Mandaluyong, if we just take this up very quickly. We have already started this, and so that the gentleman here again can get back to the respective office right away. So the first part that you have to ask, of course, Attorney Chito Cruz, or probably Attorney Bernardo, in your opinion, what's your comment on the name, change of name, Department of Housing and Urban Development, of the Department of Human Settlement and Urban Development?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, allow us to manifest our agency's appreciation to you, Mr. Senator, and to the men and women of your committee for your sustained efforts in sponsoring Senate Bill 2691. This bill is without a doubt is another step towards our common goal of providing the Filipino people with safe, resilient, decent, and affordable homes. The proposal to create the Department of Human Settlement and Urban Development is a long-standing advocacy, the revival of which we find timely and appropriate. The proposed amendments in said bill is designed to create a full-fledged line agency in charge of not only housing concern, but puts forth the institutional mechanism that will allow us to face the complex and ever-increasing challenges in human settlements and urban development. With the passage of this piece of legislation, a stronger national government institution will be established to respond to the rapidly accumulating housing needs. Likewise, with the bill's emphasis on urban development, the DSHUD shall be able to address issues such as rapid urban population growth, lack of integration of urban and regional development, ineffective urban planning, and increasing LGU capacities in human settlements and urban development. It is for this reason, Mr. Chairman, that we fully support this bill.
Thank you very much, Mr. Michitukus, our chairman, Francie. Thank you very much for your support of for this legislation. Maybe I'll just ask the other questions later. No? I will ask the Baccarat's protest for their statements like for this tax proceeding. Attorney Bernardo, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, just like our chair, we fully support this bill. I think this has been a long time in coming, this department. And with respect to the question of the Honorable Chair regarding the change of name from DHUD to Department of Human Settlement and Urban Development, we totally agree with this change in name because human settlement is more, is broader and is more encompassing. Rather than just talk about housing, we want to talk about sustainable communities and therefore human settlement as an all-encompassing term is much better than just Department of Housing and Urban Development. So we totally support this new name.
About the Attorney Chito Cruz, do you share the same opinion?
We share the same opinion, Mr. Chairman.
But the chair for the report is that I do not know if the opinion is like this because it sounds like a Marcos era department.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
But I know that it's more of a passing, no? Yes. Chairman Bacarich, first of all, friends from GSLS, attorney to you, Mr. Oliver Perez, again, gentlemen, for your position on the said measure.
Thank you. Excuse me. Thank you, Your Honor. As I stated in the previous hearing, we support the bill insofar as it tries to integrate the whole housing department into one department. However, we do have some comments on some provision, particularly on giving the secretary a board seat in the GSIS, considering that the GSIS has a legal mandate under its charter, which is to provide benefits to government employees, and considering the fact that recently we had already isolated ourselves from granting housing loans, and in fact we have we deem it proper, GSIS deem it proper that it be given to the several government agencies on housing, so that GSIS can concentrate on its legal mandate of being the trust administrator of pension fund and retirement benefits of government employees. Another is insofar as it gives the DHUD the power to on the disposition of lands not only related to housing but also in other assets of the GOCCs, considering that the GSIS has a mandate also to dispose of its acquired assets, which are mostly foreclosed assets because of the loans granted to the members. And I think that's all about it, Your Honor. But we leave it to the discretion of the committee and the Honorable Senate whether this be adopted, but we suggest that it be seriously reconsidered.
Thank you, Attorney. You are a member of the provincial of the Department of Housing, but the decision on inclusion of the secretary as ex officio
member
of the GSIS board.
And of course, the role of the DHUD insofar as it has a say on the disposition of acquired assets of the GOCCs. It may overlap with the function of the board and the management of GSIS as far as disposition of the acquired asset is concerned.
Okay, thank you. At this point, I would like to ask SFS for your presentation, and also if you have a statement to spread your thanks.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. Similar to our colleagues in the from the shelter agencies, we would like to express our support for the creation of the Department of Housing, and as suggested, the renaming it to Department of Human Settlements. We feel that it will be a critical factor in supporting a sustainable housing program, especially with an appropriate organizational structure. But we echo the same sentiment as our colleague from GSIS. We feel that an additional board seat in the Social Security Commission may not be, we have reservations with regards to that provision. The rationale behind the membership of the SSC or the Social Security Commission is the tripartite representation of SSS major stakeholders. And at the moment, we feel that it is already adequately represented by members of the labor, of management, as well as from government. Having said that, we of course leave it to the discretion and wisdom of this committee to pursue the provisions as it sees fit. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Marie Ada de Silva. Attorney Dr. Capillo, forgive me, please, ma'am. Preparation on the declaration, and I like to change of name.
Yeah. Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. Pag-ibig Fund is already is consistent in its concurrence to the creation of the department, the DHUL. That there is an urgent need of really of creating the department, and when it comes to the name, there's no problem with it. I mean, we concur with the change of name. We have, however, a comment on the on some of the provisions in regards to the attachment of Pag-ibig Fund to the department to be created. We also concur with the attachment of Pag-ibig Fund, but only in so far as for the purposes of policy and program coordination. And when it comes also to the role of the secretary to the Pag-ibig Fund Board of Trustees, under the bill, it says that the secretary shall be elected as chairman, whereas in our charter, the secretary, the chairperson of the HADC, is the ex-officio chairman of the board. And then on the establishment of the adjudication commission, an independent commission within the department, we propose some provisions to be included, because in the exercise of the exclusive jurisdiction of this commission, in adjudicating the cases, complaints between the developer and the buyer and the landowners, usually our borrowers might use these complaints to stop paying their obligations with us if they have housing obligations. So we propose an additional provision in that particular section to include the provision that the borrowers are required to comply with their contractual obligations with Pag-ibig Fund to pay their housing loan amortizations unless they have secured a TRO or a restraining order or an injunction for that. And that's it. That's it, Chairman.
Okay, thank you, Bernie Capilli. Last but not least, representing of PGC, Mr. Falcon of NEDA. Mr. Raman Falcon, can we get the petition of NEDA regarding the creation?
Yeah. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, Your Honor. The NEDA reiterated support to the creation of the Department of Housing and Urban Development as provided in the our building development plan for 2011-2016 PDP, and on the issue of the working and also developing policies, plans, programs, and projects for a more efficient and rational approach to housing and urban development issues. Combining centralized planning and policy making with the program, which is our function, is being favorable for the country. And this can very well be achieved by improving the way for the national agencies such as the Bureau to spearhead the formulation of the national urban development and housing plans, policies, and strategies for allowing our private sales and independent cities to implement and implement these policies. We would just like to reiterate that it is necessary for the DBO to work closely with the other national government agencies such as the DBO, the Department of Finance, the UNEDA, the SWP, in the other agencies for special agencies in identifying the policies, the direction, and the strategies in the housing and urban development sector. On the way, Chairman, Your Honor, we continue to support this bill as it has been a legislative agenda in previous Philippine development plans, and we will continue to support the same. Thank you very much. Good afternoon.
Hey, thank you, Mr. Falcon. Before we continue, I'd just like to ask again the villages to submit the position papers, no? On or before October 15th so that we can proceed with the technical working group for the DHAB. But before we proceed also, so we can already dismiss all of you, and the additional staff has about 3 points, three concerns. First is what are the factors that may be constraining the key shelter agencies in performing the ideal roles? Anybody? Probably we could start with the shelter manager, Tony Pagunsan. And likewise, siguro yung position na lang tayo. Sorry that you forgot to answer it earlier.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. The NHA expresses its support for the enactment of the bill spending before this committee. As contained in our position paper when it's submitted to this committee, there are certain reservations on the part of the National Housing Authority, and this would be in respect to provisions in the bill spending with respect to the powers and functions of the Department of Housing vis-a-vis that of the National Housing Authority. We have noted, Mr. Chair, that there are provisions in the bill spending that refer to powers of the department to implement or that may possibly overlap or encroach with the production function of the National Housing Authority. And on this aspect, we would like to seek a review or perhaps maybe to recap certain provisions so that the possible overlaps may be avoided. So the position of the National Housing Authority is that under EO 90, the National Housing Authority is still the sole producer, the sole production arm of housing production arm of the government, and we hope that the committee will look into this and maintain that power that is being lodged with the National Housing Authority. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Attorney Manager, Attorney Pagunsan. Anybody can answer that from last year at HLURB. So, are there any factors that are constraining your performing roles? No? So, that would be a Department of Health that would be advantageous for all the other government housing agencies.
Mr. Jaman, in part of HADC, at the moment, HADC lacks the mandate and organizational infrastructure to manage a national urban and shelter policy and address the issues on housing and urban development. These national issues will require national policy and strategy leadership and management that current HADC mandate and organization cannot sufficiently provide. As provided in our mandate, EO 90, which was created in 1986, our task is limited to formulating national objectives and designing broad strategies for housing and urban development, and merely coordinating activities of government agencies undertaking housing projects. With this new bill, HADC will have the mandate and will have the organizational structure to fulfill its role. Likewise, HADC lacks at the moment lacks resources in terms of manpower, financial, and technical to realistically take the proper leadership and management of the urban development shelter. Our current institutional capacities and resources cannot match the magnitude of the issues that is to be addressed. Lastly, HADC lacks the authority and organizational infrastructure to effectively exercise the assigned administrative and technical supervision of its attached housing agency. HADC has limited administrative structure only and has hampered effective supervision of the policies and programs of its attached agency. I guess with this new bill, we will have greater coordination, greater mandate over the other key shelter agencies.
Thank you, Attorney Cruz. Attorney Bernardo.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. In addition to what Chairman Cruz said, definitely having a department would have a lot of advantages because right now, HADC is just a coordinating council and there are, you know, key shelter agencies under it. All the great things that the department will put it apart from other department. Housing is such an important aspect of our economy and an important driver of national development that we need to have a full-blown department handling all housing issues. We already know how many housing units the background is and this has not been addressed properly. So having a Department of Housing will really put into focus under one organization all these problems so that all strategies, all actions, all programs can be synchronized towards the same objective. Sometimes the channel with respect to your question of what is hampering us, we just have to raise a certain issues about jurisdiction of the proposed Department of Housing and we have requested Commissioner Paredes to just give our views on the possible problems about jurisdiction, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Commissioner Paredes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Insofar as the adjudicatory functions of the HLURB is concerned right now, we have several issues regarding jurisdiction. For example, under our present charter, we have jurisdiction only over complaints filed by buyers, no? But not complaints filed by developers. So what some developers usually do is they file first before the courts, no? Their complaint against the buyer, and therefore we are therefore ousted from our jurisdiction in exercising our adjudicatory function over suits filed by buyers. That's one issue, though, which I think the present bill answers. The other issue is insofar as homeowners are concerned, although RA 9904, the Magna Carta for homeowners and homeowners associations says that it applies even to non-members. However, there is an issue of whether or not we have jurisdiction over these non-members, homeowners but non-members, because RA 9904 merely states that we have jurisdiction over intra-association disputes. It does not say that we have jurisdiction also over suits filed by or against homeowners who are not members of the association. Also, I think it is answered by this bill. The other problems you are facing is that insofar as third parties occupying the open spaces of subdivisions, we have no jurisdiction over this. So any suit for ejectment should be filed before the courts, because our jurisdiction, as I said, merely pertains to buyers. So a non-buyer is beyond our jurisdiction. So these issues, Your Honor, has already been answered, I think, in this bill.
Hey, thank you, Mr. Paredes. This is one of the more issues that is raised by the employees, because when this comes into realization, some employees opposite me na the creative of the public housing may not be able to accommodate everybody, but I'll just like to ask the public people to say this to you, no? How many employees in actually HL you are currently enjoying security system? Do you have any?
We don't have any data on that, Mr. Chair, but since the agencies are here, they are in a better position to give that figure, ano? And gusto ko lang idagdag, we are integrating several agencies here, and we have existing law already on government reorganization, and we must take note of that, RA 6656. And I suggest that as early as now, mabuti at inilabas nyo kung ilan yung maapektuhan, as early as now, the different agencies should have that figure already. Kasi mahirap na pag-implement, ang daming pupunta sa CSE, magre-reklamo, mag-a-appeal na hindi nasunod ang RA 6656 or na-displace sila. Actually, that's our concern here.
Okay, Tony Cruz, number of employees, okay. So we have an idea.
As far as HATS is concerned, Mr. Chair, we have 80 to 90 permanent employees, plus about 40 contract of services. And so far as HLURB is concerned, they have 422 permanent employees. So these are the employees that will be affected by this bill.
Yes, I was mentioned by the chair, 422 permanent employees. But Mr. Chair, I think the concern about displacing employees may not altogether be realistic, because as in fact we may even have to add later on employees, because right now, for example, HLURB is present in only 9 administrative regions. And under this bill, of course, as a department, we have to be represented in all administrative regions. So we will probably or most likely have to add. So I don't think there's any displacement. There's a provision in the principal provisions of somewhere where it says the present employees will be absorbed unless they opt to retire. So I think that's less of a concern, Mr. Chairman.
Well, that's good to hear that we will not have a problem with displacement. In fact, we will. As we said, we might need, there is a need to add in case the department is out of form. But we have last but not least, are there any proposed power functions of the Department of Housing that have not been discharged by both HLURB and HADSI? Do you have any proposal on whatever functions na sa tingin nyo hindi pa takover ng dalawang department or agency that can be added to the definition of the Department of Housing?
Well, I think as far as that is concerned, this has been fully covered by the bill, Mr. Chairman.
Silver Bill Chairman, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, thank you very much, gentlemen. The chair just thanked you for the presentation of the position papers so that we can dismiss all of you already this afternoon. So we can already proceed to the next item of the agenda. Thank you, Tony Cruz. If it's not asking too much regarding the bill, I would like to ask Attorney Patterson, there might be some concerns to stay for a while. And if you are being at the point of conditional penalties, I don't want to open them. And only by the time, actually, Tony Cruz. You can stay. Okay, thank you, sir. this is this a new this a new item? We will just we will also wait for Senator Osmeña to join us shortly. But in the meantime, we will now continue. At this point, I would like to ask, of course, Mayor Avalos, for your statement regarding the Heartbeat 4-2-4 regarding the welfare bill.
Thank you all so much, Senator Ejercito. Magandang hapon po sa lahat. My office is in full support of this House bill filed by Congressman Gonzalez number 4049, which calls for the disposition of welfare bill for the settlers in welfare bill. In relation to this, I would like to point out that when I was a congressman, I also filed a bill which is now an act that amended Section 12 of Republic Act Number 7279, otherwise known as the Urban Development and Housing Act of 1992. What is important in this bill that I'd filed before, it is about Section 12, Mr. Senator, which is for the disposition of lands for socialized housing. Inilagay ko po rito, no, particular that the NHA with respect to lands belonging to the national government and the local government units with respect to the other lands within the respective shall coordinate with each other to formulate and make available various alternative schemes for the disposition of lands to the beneficiaries of the program. So these are lands owned by the national government sold. Pero ang importante na ilagay ko po rito at naging batas na po ito ay it could not be done through direct negotiated sale. Wala nang bidding-bidding, no? So, nakalagay po ito, disposition of lands including any improvements thereon owned by the national government and or any of its agencies or instrumentalities units through direct negotiated sale to the occupants thereof without need of public bidding shall be allowed subject to several conditions, no? So, minilagay naman conditions dito. Again, this is the Republic Act Number 9397, which was approved by Congress of the Philippines year 2006. I'm just, naku, maganda nga po po, Sir Tosmeña. I'm just citing this law in relation to what is now pending, no? Ito pong batas ni Congressman Gonzalez, it is more specific now that it is welfare bill. Yung pong batas na naigawa ko ay sa Pilipinas po ito. So kung ano ba ang kapulangan sa ginawa ng araw, ito na po ang sasalo rito, no? At ako ay naniniwala na siguro if you are going to visit welfare bill right now, it's the biggest barangay not only in Mandaluyong but probably in Metro Manila right now, and people have been there for the last 50 years. It has been developed, we have our own schools, church, it's a big community. I believe that I support this bill of filed by Congressman Gonzalez. At importante po naman dito, yung mismong mental hospital, yung mismong hospital, hindi po kasama yung may mga hospital at hindi rin naman kasama yung kumulan, no, sa correctional, no. Okay. So, in ending, I ask my Magdaluyo, we are in full support of this House bill. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mayor Avalos. This is my chair, my top knowledge, President of Senator Sotomayor. Thank you, sir, for joining our hearing. Likewise, Senator Gregorio Masap. Next, recognize President Captain Posadas or Brother Engineers, Mandaluyong City. Sir, yung inyong proposition tungkol sa sinasabi ng Manokan Bukas.
Good morning, Chairman. Senator Osmeña, Senator Masan, sa aming dating Mayor Benjamin Avalos. Yung sinabi nga po ni Mayor na katatapos na hindi po yung totoo na nangyari sa barangay edition sa welfare bill. Na kami po ay matagal na pala yung buwan na to at madikado na po. Kaya sa kahilingan po namin ang matiga Rector Bilay, sana ay mabigyan kami ng pagkakataon na mapasa amin ang totoong pangunahan sa Rector Bilay. Yung po ang kahilingan namin sa posisyon ko bilang ama ng barangay. Kaya nga, ako po, bilang ama ng barangay, ay talaga na sa pagkakataon ito na ang aking pagkasiya na ako po yung napasalita dito sa harapan niyo. Parang masabi ko po na talagang matagal na kami inilaan dyan sa lugar na yan. Kaya nga, sorry po. Kaya nga po yung buhay niyo sabi, Mr. Chairman, sa mga mong panahon, napipanood po po yung nagyot o pangawating. Ang tingin namin, ang tayo niya is pinanin ni Dr. Rita. Dinilig na namin mga namayo ba ng Rapalos at Consular Bayot Rosales ang aming dahil. We hope you also be with us. Let us all join me. Together for us a future of the justice and dignity. Ilan po ang nagkalingan sa inyo. Maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat po para ng ating posadas ng Barangay Issue Deals. Si Mr. Rodrigo Padrigon ng World Barbier
Peter Tsingvima. Magandang hapon po, Mr. Chair. Kami po sa samahan ng World Barbier Peter's Assembly, isang po ng maraming samahan sa loob ng World Barbier, ay buong-buong namin support na buo doon sa House Bill na Adipat-Lipat 9397 ng aming mayor at ang House Bill 4339 na kung saan ay nais namin maamintahan yung Republic of 1560 na nagwa lilimita sa amin na mabili ang lupa ng Walter Bill. Dahil yung sa pito ng Republic of 1560 paling public meeting naman gusto nyo mangyari. Kaya wala kaming pang para makalahot sa meeting. Kaya ang kahilingan po ng mga taga-Walter Bill ay maamintahan po yung Republic of 1560 at supportan po yung House Bill 4349 at yung Republic of 1997. Yun lang po, Mr. Chair.
Maraming salamat po, Mr. Pedrito Padigon. The chair would like to ask probably Mayor Benio Abelos. No? The Republic Act 5260 was enacted in the year 1968. Tama ho ba, no? Tama.
Yes, sir.
Hindi ko rin kami. Declared the Republic as alienable and disposable land of the state. It further authorized the state of the sale of the property to a public bidding. Ano ang nangyari? Bakit hindi po natuloy implementation? Just for the, of course, for the benefits of our committee members.
Okay. Yung po kasing nangyari po rito sa bidding, nung ako po yung congressman, ako po ay napanukala na isang batas na naging Republic Act number 9397. Ang ito po ay amendment sa Udhalo, no? Ang isa pong provision dito, babasahin ko lang po, no? Tinanggal po yung bidding. No, ang ginawa po dito, disposition of lands including any improvements or owned by the national government or any of its agencies or instrumentalities of the local government units through direct negotiated sale to the occupants or without need of public bidding shall be allowed subject to the following conditions. Very stringent po yung conditions, no? Number one, the lands are within a residential zone as classified by the LGUs. Number two, the lands are certified to be for authorized housing proposed by the HUDC. Number three, the occupants are qualified beneficiaries in accordance to Section 16. The cost of land shall be made affordable to the beneficiaries, taking into account. In short, ito po ay, ang pangalap ng counterpart ko po nito ay si Senator Biason. So, ito po ang naging amendment sa Udhalo.
ang nangyari na po, Seto Ejercito, ito palang sa Welfare Bill, parang special law, no? So, dahil special law siya, ito pong sinasabi kong batas, parang nagkaroon ng konting kakulangan. So, Congressman Gonzales is trying to cure this defect by passing this House Bill number 4349 to do away with this meaning. Baka pwedeng i-negotiated sale na sa mga tao.
How big the property is in Burwata to you? Para po naman in the home, in the area, in the home, yung residence na nakatira.
Yes, sir.
As of the moment.
Yes, sir. It's about 120 hectares. 180 hectares. Well, what the population is about... the house owners 2013 is about 11,000. Yes, sir. Gusto ko lang pong emphasize po, nasa house bill po rito, no, hindi po isasakop yung mismo aktual na tinatayuan ng mental hospital tsaka po ng correctional, no. Yun lang pong sa labas na okupado po ng mga tao.
Ito po yung sa main lobby?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, excluding mental hospital facilities?
Yes, sir. The facilities. Yung unoccupied po. Yes, sir.
Just like the chair that was HADSI or MHLRB, kung meron mo kayong opinion tungkol dito?
Well, it's so far po as HADSI is concerned, we support the measure because if and when this bill is passed, this will generate about 11,000 socialized housing for the residents of Welfareville. No, we just want probably to add. Maybe we can also include some improvement in the area, such as making sure ensuring that the proper reblocking of the streets and introduction of other services can be included in the measure, so that place will not remain blighted. Probably we can, because the landlord is the welfare bill sits very very expensive. Maybe we can also consider going up instead of just distributing the land. Maybe some of the residents may want to go to consider building low-rise buildings so that we can accommodate more in the area. So probably we can make the study for that.
Well, thank you, Tony Cruz. Tony Bernardo.
Chairman, I concur with what Tony Cruz said.
Thank you. Mayor, do you have a full development plan or as is na lang mo ito?
Hindi ako pakinggan sa pinasang batas ni Congressman Gonzales, no? Pero gusto ko lang emphasize na bukod po sa mental hospital, bukod po sa correctional, meron po din pong mga DOH doon, no? Which is about 12,000 square meters, Department of Health. May popcorn po, doon po yung popcorn, which is about 16,000. Meron po NTC, no? National Telecommunications, which is about 2,500 square meters. Meron po TESDA, which is about 4,000. And not mentioning the fact, may mga simbahan, may mga eskwalahan, at a lot of road networks. So, ang suma po nito ay maliit na lang po. Hindi po ganun kalaki. Kamukha na iniisip nating kalakihan. At kung ikukumpira po natin, if you will help a visit there, Mr. Senator, malaki na po talagang pinagbago ng welfare bill. Hindi kamukha nung araw na puro putek, puro... Ngayon po, puro ilaw na ho, puro, at saka sementado para subdivision na po. It's just that these people are not empowered. And the people right now, I think most of them have the capacity to buy the property. Tama po siguro siguro pag-usapan na natin kung ano ang tamang papaplano po rito, no? What is important here is the medium, the development goal of the United Nations, eh, talagang we're on track about this, sir.
Thank you, Mayor Adams. Senator Espeña. Senator Dice.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I just need to be clarified. Who will execute the the welfare bill disposition, which government agency, the National Housing, the City of Mandaluyong, sino po?
DSWD.
Ah, DSWD.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Secondly, can you recap, anong total area ng welfare bill? 180?
118 hectares, sir.
All right. And what is involved here dito sa certain portions? How many hectares is that? I, an act declaring certain portions. Eh, hindi ko alam anong total portion, anong total area nito.
Mr. Senator, can I call over our head of one of the members of the Welfare Trustee Committee who is more knowledgeable about the area?
We do
answer these technical
issues. With permission of the chair, yes.
Please, please.
Thank you.
Good afternoon po. Ako po si Mr. Herwin Yu Blanco po. Ang current IC ng Welfare Bill Commission po. About po dun sa land area po. Kasi po yung mental hospital at saka yung correctional po, sinasama po ko lang.
Anong area nitong certain portions?
Actually, hindi po na the law sa
declares that certain portions of welfare bill shall be open for disposition to the residents without public bidding. I want to know what's the amount. What's the area?
Actually, doon po sa loan na ipinasa ni Congressman Gonzales, hindi po siya specific doon kung ano yung portion, second portion
na yan.
Kasi po, ang dami pa po natin diyang mga yung sinasabi po ni Mayor kanina na mga yung PUBCOM, yung NTC, ibabawas pa po yun doon sa 110 hectares eh.
That's not an explanation. We want to know exactly how much is going to be disposed of without public bidding. Yeah, that's what I'm going to ask them next. Yeah.
Wala po kasing specific na nakalagay.
Mr. Chair. Mr. Senator, reading through the law, which is Section 2, ang nakasaad po kasi dito sa batas ni Congressman is the welfare bill property except the areas occupied by the National Center for Mental Health and the Correctional Institute for Women is hereby declared disposable and alienable and shall be sold through direct negotiated sale to bona fide residents therein without public bidding. Parang yun po ang sinasabi niyang portion.
So, well, I'm sorry, but I disagree, no? I think the exact area should be established. 180 hectares is a lot of land. All right? And there'll be a lot of shenanigans going on because we're giving you blanket authority to dispose of anything and you don't even measure what are those areas that you're removing from disposition. So we'd like to, with your permission, Mr. Chair, we'd like them to submit the map. We'd like the exact measurements. Now, paano po ito pinipili? Bakit lahat ba ng hindi ginagamit ng ano yun? National Center for Mental Health and Correctional Institute for Women? Everything else is disposable now?
Parang ganun po lumalabas sa bill na final po rito ni Congressman, no?
I would like to register a reservation already at this time, Mr. Chair. We'd like to have the statistics. We'd like to know exactly how many hectares are going to be disposed of. Then my second question is that fully occupied now by illegal settlers?
No, sir.
The whole place?
No, sir.
So why are we disposing of it if it's wala nang presyo? Kung nandito po sila, Matagal na po kayo doon, no?
Oh. And, I'm sorry, sir. I'm so sorry. Yung pong mental hospital is not occupied by the settlers? Yung pong...
No, I think the mental hospital and the correctional institute, is everything else occupied already?
Well, aside from the churches, the schools, almost everything is already occupied there, okay. Mr. Senator.
Now, these are single or double-story homes only, no?
Yes, sir.
Nakakampanya na ako dun, so... Alright, so having said that, that would be a very inefficient use of land. That's another reservation I have. Sa ngayon po sila, siguro hindi makakapasok yung fire truck doon.
Ah, hindi makakapasok po. Pagkago na po ngayon, may mga malalaking kali na po napagawa.
Some.
Hindi po, halos, I would say about 70%, 80% po.
In other words, before you come in, you have to plan out the roads first because kung hindi, hindi makakapasok garbage truck, hindi maka, kung may sunog, hindi makakapasok ang fire truck. Makikita ko yung ang liit-liit ng mga iskinito dun eh. So, we'd like to see a master plan. Secondly, we'd like to have maybe the NHA just develop medium-rise house housing so there's more open space. So, it becomes a more livable area. With the same rights given to the present occupants. Pero huwag natin sabihin na that's going to be a permanent situation where anybody can build anything he wants. Di ba? I mean, you will have a model resettlement project. You can even get big developers coming in to do the medium rise. Then you'll have more units, but you'll have more open space also. So that's the type of planning we'd like to see in the areas where we do have... I am in favor of government disposing the land to the occupiers. We lack housing in Manila, kaya ako parati nakikita na wherever there is space, masking yung sa Rojas Boulevard, nakatago lang sila, pero sa seawall, nandun po yung mga, hindi naman bahay, pero yung campsite nila. So, maybe with the help of the HVDCC, the HLURB, the NHA, and the Office of the Mayor, we can have a more intelligent plan here. Singapore did it, no? But Singapore is Singapore. They have limited land, so they built up condominium style. Kasi sinabi ni Lee Kuan Yew, if I didn't let them own the unit, they will not take care of the common areas. Ganun rin sila dun. Pero yung nagiging owner sila, di inalagaan na yung kuan, yung mga common areas, yung mga corridors. And we want to see that happening also. So ayaw ko dito na, di akin ito eh, pero yan, hindi akin yan. So tapon mo lang yung basura doon. No, we'd like the garbage also to be taken care of. And yung mga bata na naglalaro sa kalye, ginagawang basketballan, ginagawang soccer field. Let's have plans already na merong open space para the kids can use it. Ilang pamilya po kayo dyan? Anong estimate? How many families are you there?
Sa ngayon, meron mga 90,000 katao.
90,000
katao.
Individuals.
Katao.
Pero kung by residence, by home.
Dalawang pangilipin struktura.
Ha?
Dalawang pangilipin.
20,000, so about 4.5 per structure.
Mr. Chair, dagdag pa ho dyan. Mayroon na pong nagalag na World Bank Master Development Plan dito na pinindihan ng World Bank.
Sino nag-approve niyan? Inapprovehan ba ng
Social Development? Executive Order 156.
Ano?
Executive Order 156. Panahon po ni Fidel Ramos.
Yeah. Anyway, lahat yan. We will take that into consideration, no, Mr. Chairman. Existing laws, existing regulations. But I think, Mayor, you'll have a good opportunity here to set up a model redevelopment area which can be followed by Cebu and Cagayan de Oro and Davao, instead of looking at yung mga bahala na, basta distribute na natin yan. We can use the resources of government to start building up and allowing our people to enjoy a better quality and higher quality of life. Yan po ang gusto ko makita sana, no? Wala rin kayong kwan dyan. Wala kayong may sewerage system ba kayo dyan?
Meron po.
Bawat bahay po. No? Bawat bahay, may Poso Negro.
Meron po.
That's the whole problem, eh. Napupuno po yan. So, a developer will be required to have a central collection of sewage, water and sewer, electricity, telecoms. Parang gumanda naman yung ang buhay ng mga anak natin. Di ba? Katapos, because it's properly done, properly maintained, mas gaganda yung resale value. Halimbawa, matandaan na ho kayo, gusto ho kayo ninyong bumalik dun sa probinsya, you can sell the property. Then you also want to set up common areas for eating and shopping. And natural naman yan, maraming papasok yan. Sigurado ko papasok ang McDonald's, papasok ang Jollibee. So let's have a neat place already set aside for them where they can. Ang laki ng 180 hectares. All of Forbes and Das Malinas is only 700 hectares. And then maybe later on we can move the correctional institution elsewhere. Diba?
Actually, in Santa Spina, we're proud of that. It's a right, probably, when I was to visit, we have already started an in-situ housing with the help of, with the support of, with John
Matabuchi.
Yes, sir. And Hagsi, medium-rise housing.
Ganda. How many stories? Six?
Five. This is a joint project with NHA and Hagsi. Ang city government na ng land.
Ngayon po, this is owned by the national government, no? Did you research the title?
Yes, sir. It's owned by the Department of DSWD.
Okay. Yes, I want you just to go back in history and find out if this land was donated.
It was donated, sir. It was.
Who was the donor? Fabelia?
Fabelia, sir. Yes.
They owned all of the land there?
Yes, sir.
Jose Rizal College is Fabelia.
Yes, sir.
Fabelia.
Yes,
all right. Now, make sure that there is no condition.
That's why, sir, in this house bill, no. I think the condition should be the proceeds should go to this children's fund.
You have to talk to the Fabelia family first. If there's a condition, I'm here by selling this for a low price or donating it for the use of, ganun. It's only for that use. Hindi mo mababawi yan, hindi mo ma-improve yan. They'll put a claim. Then we will be in court for 20 years. So, we can talk to the Fabelias already if you commercialize this. O sige, kung may konting kita, you tell the Fabelias, o, ati tayo. Pero mag-o-object yan, yung mga AS nila, gaya yung mga nag-donate dun sa Camp Crame. Those are conditioned on the use of this as an army camp. Pag tinanggal mo yan, and you change the use, they can take back the property. So, ating kapatid na lang, say, sige, ibenta natin ito. You get one half, which you will never enjoy unless I agree also. Get it? So let's find out, huh?
So in relation with this, you know, I got two notes here. way back 1968 that I finally will read this note. The disposition of Proper Bill is covered by the Public Act number 5260 approved June 1968, authorizing a committee composed of the Administrator of the Social Welfare Administration, the Auditor General, and the Secretary of the Department of General Services to sell the Proper Bill located in the municipality of Mandaluyong, province of Visayas for other purposes. This disposition sale never materialized up to the president, and the traffic committee has not been convened. So in this reference, there were times that several presidents had tried to sell Proper Bill several years ago. So I think in this respect, if they try to do that, there is no condition. There's no condition with reference to the donation.
Maybe that's why they were not able to sell it.
But no, sir, there were no takers. There was a failure of bidding the last time. And in fact, what Mandaluyong did, we have this ordinance that will only be for residential.
If there was a failure of bidding, can you remember who were the bidders?
I think it was Robinson's before. Parang Maripo. Parang ganon eh. If I memory recalls me right.
All right, maybe we can inquire from Robinson,
yes,
which is Gokong Wei, no?
Yes, sir.
And Ayala, whether...
Because
they had studied the property, because they would know if there's a condition on the title. Or they call it CCNRs, conditions, yes, covenant, and restrictions. So let's find. Let's do our homework first now.
Yes, sir. We'll check on that, sir.
Before we have all these grandiose plans and we find out, oops, mali.
We objected on that, the city object. In fact, the zoning of that area would only be for residential R1 up to now.
Yes.
It was passed by the local government of Mandaluyong.
Then Mandaluyong might see it in their best interest to increase the density to allow 5 stories. So what do you call that? R3, yeah.
Yes, sir.
And even some commercial, because you're going to want to invite some commercial establishments there to service. God, you've got 20,000?
How much?
You got a lot of business to do there, diba? That's all I have for now. In seeing the map first, and then.
Pwede mo makapasunod pa, Sir Chair?
Sige pa,
business of life. Kaya, gusto ko sana namin, masasunod ng portfolio namin para makausap na namin. Para yung pag-asa namin, para sa mga anak namin, ay makamta namin. Yun po ang inyo po.
Mr. Senator, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Mr. Mayor Abalos.
Kaya po ganun si Kapitan, dahil ilang beses tinangkang ibenta po ang welfare bill at paalisin yung mga tao. Kaya po ganun ang emosyon ng mga tao po ngayon dito. At kapag po na sinasabi nga, yung pong nanayot po kami sa United Nations, eh, we were given an award last month in Medellin, Colombia. It's the best school for special children. It's now a template for third world countries. And that school for special children is in welfare bill. No? So, malaki na po talaga yung pinagbago, yung kapasidad ng tao. Although nagkaroon po tayo ng konting technicalities lang po nito sa pag-aayos, ando po kumisan yung fear kasi ng mga mamamayan na paalisin. Kung bibilin din lang naman, mag-iipon po nila yun eh. Mag-iipon po ang tao at kukunin, no, sa tamang halaga po. Yun ang laban ang hinihingi dito yung pagkakataong mabili. Although may point din po naman kayo na siguro sabit po namin na talagang kasi tiyatanong po ni Senador kung may condition daw ang mga favela. Eh sabi ko, tingin ko may condition daw ilang beses na binibigit ang good work po. Di ba? Opos tayo na opos dun eh. Pero we need to submit those, sir, kung sakali man po yung pong hiningi nyo about these conditions and the other things.
Mr. Chairman?
Senator Nasan, is it recognized?
I would like, with the permission of Senator Osmeña, to proceed from where Senator Osmeña, hindi ho kine-question yung proseso na yon, Mayor Lenor, no? Kaya lang, dahil nilagay nyo kami rito para planuhin ito sa aspeto ng pambansang programa. Kung ano ang gagawin natin sa welfare bill, ay gagawin din natin sa ibang pareho ang sitwasyon sa buong bansa. So, sa puntong yan, hinihiling lang namin na sa pagkakataong ito, we have to start thinking not as residents of Mandaluyong or welfare bill, but as Filipinos. One nation. Okay, let me proceed. Tinanong ni Senator Osmeña kung meron tayong data. Procedural ho ito eh, yung pagbebenta, madali ho yan. Una-una, tinanong ni Senator Osmeña, bakit tumanggi ang Robinsons? Baka may alam sila na hindi natin alam. Kailangan malaman natin yan. But babalik ako ngayon kay Kapitan Posadas. Ang population ninyo ay 90,000.
Apa, sir?
Hindi ko ito sinasabi dahil re-electionist si Senator Osmeña. Mabuti kami ni Senator JB hanggang 2019 pa kami. Ilan ang botante sa...
As of now, 46,000 po.
6,000?
46.
Ah, 46. I'm sorry. Ilan ang bata?
Ano ba?
Yun nga ho.
18 years old?
Yun nga ho. Kailangan, itatanong ko naman, ilan ang minor de edad, ilan ang sanggol. Okay. So, kailangan ho, malaman din natin yan, no? Ngayon, I'll be going all over the place, no, so that you can get a more comprehensive view. Sa NHA, kung ituloy natin ito, gano'ng katagal i-relocate yung 90,000 into medium? Do you have any experience on this? Dahil siyempre ho, hindi yun, it's not a time and motion thing where gawa tayo ng medium rise. Where do we place them? These are practical applications of what we plan to do. Hindi ba? I mean, you have to tell us if you disagree.
Well, katulad po nung may ginawa kami sa Mandaluyong itself na 5-story building. Uh-huh. Ang normally po niyan yung paggawa niyan, it would take yung bidding po process is about 3 months and then yung construction period po for a 5-story building normally po, katulad sa Sarawak, parang po yan. So, isang taon po yung natin tatapusin yung mga tower per cluster po. Hindi na naman po natin po pwedeng lahat sabay-sabay. Ano po?
Okay lang po, naintindihan natin yan. No? Ang tinatanong lang is may karanasan ba tayo? Dahil kailangan harapin natin ang sitwasyon. No? Habang kinoconstruct yan within 1 year, nasaan yung 90,000? Okay, you don't have to answer. That's the point of Senator Osmeña. For us to make an informed decision that will not only involve welfare bill or Mandaluyong, but the entire country. similarly situated, we have to do, we do not have, only have to do this right, we have to do this well. Okay. Second, babalik ako ngayon kay Kapitan Posadas at kay President Mang Pedring, no? Dito sa mga bata, ilan ang nag-aaral? Kailangan natin yung data niya. Kumusta ang kalusugan nila? Naasikaso ba? Tama, may eskwelahan. Dahil, sinasabi ko ito sa inyo, Mayor Benhur, no? Yung mga mas bata sa amin dito, including Senator JB, pag wala na kami, well, pag wala na ako, not Senator Osmeña, no? Our most important, precious, strategic, and renewable resource are our children. Yun ang taya natin sa kinabukasan. So, mahalaga na mapangalagaan natin yung edukasyon. Make them healthier, smarter, safer, happier. So, nakatutuko tayo dyan. Habang kinukonstruct ito within 1 year, Chairman Cruz, what do with these children? Will there be any disruption in their day-to-day lives? Pag nagkasunog habang may construction, nakita naman ninyo yung traffic natin ngayon. Makakapasok ba ron yung bumbero na tiga-ibang municipality? That's, mawalang galang ko sa inyo. Naunawaan namin, 4 na dekada na kayong nandyan. Pero hindi ito within welfare bilang. Dahil, sabi sa Article 3, huwag mo kayong magugulat, hindi naman ako abogado. Protect life, buhay, liberty, kalayaan, at property, pag-aari na pinaghirapan at itinayo ninyo within 40 years. That's the perspective that we just want to suggest to you so that you can provide, as requested by Senator Osmeña, the complete data that will allow us to make an informed, timely, rational, intelligent, long-term policy decision. Ano, kung nagtiis kayo ng 40 years, ito ho, ilang linggo lang ho ito. Once you get the data in, we can make a decision. But in the meantime, pag-depensa ho ni Senator JB nito on the floor, abe, kaawa-awa naman siya. Eh kung tanungin siya nung 21 na magagaling nating senador, na may mga katanungan din sa kanilang puso at isip, kailangan masagot naman ni Senator JV. So it's all about people, no? Our most important resource. So, pag sinabi namin, ilang ang population? 90,000. Kuminsan, so, tumitigil na tayo rin eh. Para bang ang buhay ay numero lamang. Ang gusto namin is not the quantitative data, but the qualitative data. How are they? Buhay pa ba sila? Nag-iingat na ba? Masaya ba? Ligtas ba sa krimen? Sa mga drug pusher, sa mga kriminal? Yun ang kailangan malaman namin para pagtalakay nito. Didesisyonan natin to, procedural ito, once all the data are in. And finally, I suggest, Mayor Benhur, that you look at this beyond your term as mayor, because you'll not be forever mayor. One of these days, you'll be sitting where we are sitting now. I'll be conducting a hearing. Or, I don't know, you might be sitting in Malacanang, I don't know. And you have to carry this burden based on your unassailable experience as mayor of Mandaluyong. Initially thinking about welfare bill only, but then you'll be forced to think of the country. I'm just putting that forward para maintindihan ninyo kung ano ang sinisikap natin gawin dito. Long-term planning based on complete information, dealing with not only the quantitative information, but the qualitative. Mga bata ho, ngayon, bata pa lang ho yun, Kapitan Rodi ha, senior citizen silang po. Ito, alam ho natin kung ilan.
Dito sa pangalaman ko, tatlong libo ang senior citizen.
Okay. Kumusta ho sila? Ilan ang naka-wheelchair? Ano ba ang kondisyon nila? Naaalagaan ba sila?
Nakala namin.
Naniniwala ho ako sa inyo. Tinatanong ko lang ako, naaalagaan. Kami hong mga senior citizen eh. Diba? Kuminsan, alam mo na, pag yung mga bata lumalaki na, nakakalimutan na tayo, diba? Mahalaga ho yun. Ilan ang may trabaho? Hanap buhay na pang-araw-araw. Hindi yung contractual, ha? Yung may steady job. Ano ang average family income? Masaya ba sila? At
apektado ba sila pag nahuhuli sa trabaho? Saan sila nagtatrabaho dahil sa traffic? Nag-lay off ba sila? Ito ho yung mga katanungan, Chairman Cruz, that we should look at, no, Attorney Bernardo, so that your Senate, the Senate of the Filipino people, can make a rational, informed, intelligent, long-term policy decision, not only for welfare bill, but for the Filipino nation. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Salamat po.
Mr. Senator, can I just...
Thank you, Senator Rosas. Yes, Amir Abalos.
Yeah. Thank you for your suggestions, Senator Smeña, Senator Honasan. Isasabit po namin yung mga papeles po na kailangan. And in fact, we have a partnership with Asia Development Bank and the World Bank with reference yung po sinasabi po ninyong sa housing na welfare bill, no? I try to get copies of this also. But I would just to point out, sir, na hindi po namin pinabayaan yung tao because ayoko magbuhat ng pangko. Sa mga bata, we are the most healthy city in the Philippines. Sa nutrition, sa mga bata na gugutom, we are the best in nutrition for several consecutive years in Metro Manila.
Yes, sir. That, you don't have to explain that to us.
Yes.
We know you are a model city, no?
Yeah.
But I am sure you must agree with me that our children are not confined to the, how many hectares? 180 hectares. 80 hectares. 118. They go out to other municipalities.
I would just like to point out, Senator, that with reference to the welfare bill, these people are empowered.
Okay.
Yung pong servisyong dapat ibigay, like, yung pong simple lang, yung lang pong TESDA na tinatawag, yung manpower. Yung nasa welfare bill po was awarded as the best manpower in the Philippines by Jomo Villanueva 2 years ago. So, lahat po nung sinabi po ninyo, nagawa na po namin dito, although it is a slum area. Pero naunawa ko po yung gusto po ninyo ni Senator Smeña at we will submit po the documents and... I would just like also to thank Mr. Chito Cruz and yung pong grupong ito, talagang ang laki po ng bago na ginagawa nila sa Mandaluyong, no? Ang sabi lang po kasi kay Kapitang Kuyo at the rest of people here, natatakot po kasi sila pag isang-isang araw, wala na sila sa lugar na yun eh. Kaya po siguro naifalto ni Congressman eh. Yung ganun pa na takot lang po. Kaya naunawaan ko po, no? We're trying to harmonize everything with the Senate, etc. We'll submit the proper documents na kinakailangan po ninyo. So, not also to have a good Senator J.B.
Po. Governor, brotherly advice, ha?
Yes, sir.
We are planning not only for welfare of the country.
Yes, sir.
Do not agitate us. Dahil pag nahawa kami nung sama ng loob ni Kapitan Roddy at ni Pangulong Pedrito, at magalit kami, the rule is do not make important decisions when you are angry or when you are very happy. Medyo, hayaan mo natin mag-settle down yung blood pressure and then you submit your data and then we'll help each other. By the way, when Senator J.B. Defense is on the floor, you must be there to back him up. Ha? Salamat po.
Senator Smeña.
Alam po ninyo, we can make this a model for modern development of... May problema rin tayo sa Cebu eh. So pag kinakausap po yung... Ito, isang lugar, pangalan po doon, Barangay Luz, because it was named after the widow of President Magsaysay. Hanggang ngayon, nandun pa rin sila. Nag-aaway pa rin sila sa sarili nila. But it could have been solved a long time ago and they would have had houses. Ngayon po, 20,000 families pong sabi ninyo. Anong average size po ng dwelling po, ng bahay-bahayan dun?
Yun din sa plot po, 4x7.
28 square meters. Alright. Alam po ninyo, magkaka-construct ang gobyerno ng 100 square meters per family. Kung mag-multiple tayo. Okay, halimbawa, yung 118 hectares din. Maganap lang tayo ng 5 hectares. Kiramin natin sa correctional o anon. Ayun po yung magiging holding. So, magpapatayo ka doon ang developer, he can build 5 buildings at 5,000 square meters per floor. So 5 floors, that's 250, that's 25,000 square meters. Divided by 100, that's 250 families already. If they build 4 or 5 buildings every time, you already are able to absorb 1,000 to 1,250 families. Ayun. So magta-transfer ho yung mga pamilya doon, magkakaroon ng bakante ngayon. Doon naman magpapatayo. So in about 4 or 5 years, tapos na lahat yon. Ang gusto ko lang ho i-propose, Mr. Chairman, is that we ask the PPP to look into this. Sila ho mga experts yan, yung mga developers eh. And then, in return for some land, di ba? O sige, kumuha ka ng 20 hectares, i-develop ninyo, pero magpatayo ho kayo ng housing. Ang bayad ho yung housing, yung bagong housing na medium rise. O di, everybody happy na ngayon. Maraming maiinggit kayo sa Batasan, Addition Hills. Diba, Captain? So, proposal lang po ito. Kakausapin po natin yung PPP to add this into the program. Napakabagal pag gobyerno magpapatayo ng bahay. With all due respect to National Housing, you've got a lot of red tape. At yung sa Leyte lang, the government has only built what? Less than 10% of the required houses after Yolanda. 2 years na, nakaraan ng Yolanda. But if we had a PPP developer going in there, eh magmamadali siya first. Number one, paano siya kikita kung hindi niya tatapusin yung project, no? So, this is just a proposal. We will see if they will reject it or not. But maybe it is a consideration my colleagues will be able to take. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Senator Nasa?
Your indulgence. One last question, Chairman Cruz. Ang nagiging perennial problem namin sa Senado, cutting across the political, economic, social, and even occasionally religious landscape, is our information management system. Naipresenta naman ninyo yung budget ninyo?
Kanina po. Kanina. Okay.
But anyway, you work on this. In fact, my suggestion, Mr. Chairman, is we identify already among you who in the housing sector is the central repository of information that will be made to bear on policy decisions like this. Dapat kayo ang tinatanong namin, and we invite the mayor and the communities involved, no, to validate your information. Dahil napansin mo namin, every department, every sector, pag nagtanong na kami ng data, abe, uminsan binigyan ako ng balikbayan box eh. Ano naman ang gagawin namin doon? We do not have the capability to validate what... So, I suggest that it would be a cost-effective approach, no? Especially on the eve of the budget deliberations, no? Dahil yun ang naging problema namin. Kuminsan kami mismo nagdedebate based on conflicting data which came from you in the first place. I'm not talking about your department. So, can you please, Mr. Chairman, with your permission, work on this para yung sinabi ni Senator Sumeña, time, efficiency, energy management, in our case, we want to talk first to one person. And that person should present. And if we need validation, the technical working group natin para we can validate the data you've submitted. But remember, we're working under a tight timeline, no? Dahil alam niyo naman, these things happen. So, I strongly suggest that para the presentation will be systematic. All data in, we review it, technical working group, we ask the local governments involved, no? And then we make a decision. But on the whole, yung sinabi ni Senator Sumeña, hindi naman ho problema yung issue eh. We just want to make sure that we can back this up when we debate in plenary. Salamat po, Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Nasan. Like also, just
clear also na gusto ko lang hunin namin sa ating makasama din sa welfare bill na amin pong committee naman ay supportin mo sa anumang pagbibigay lalo na sa kakulangan sa babae ngayon, lalo na kung makakatulong kami sa 90,000 na nakatira sa inyo, tulad din ng HATSI ay kami po yung supportive doon. Kaya lang, sana inyo rin maintindihan ang aming mga kasamahan na kung ibibigay natin, gusto namin itama at nasa tama na ho. No? Tama mo yung concern sila na alam naman sa ngayon, sa totoo lang, pag dinispose po natin yan, dahil ako na gimayon din, naiintindi ako rin yung punta ni Senator Smith, Senator Hunasan. Dahil ako, ay, mga iba ng presidente, talaga nung mayroon ako, naku, kinakabawa ko pag may sunod yun, pag may tawag sa akin, naku, sana wag sa looban. Dahil pag sa looban at simula, sa gitna, by the time, dumating ang mga bumbero, malaki na apoy. Tulad nung nangyari po doon sa aming, sa St. Joseph, na po ay mabahay na. So, kung ipamimigay ang punto po ng Senator Smith, Senator Hunasan, kung pamimigay, maganda yun, nasa ayos na, yung may development plan, that's why, at this point, I would like to ask the local government, Mayor Ben Abalos, for the information no, that are being asked by the senators. One, assess value of the area, exact measurement of the area, no, kasi hindi natin masigurado kung ilang i-dispose for position. Demographics, no, yung data, no, kung ilang yung nakatira, population, senior citizens, mga bata, no, yung buwang hinihingin po natin. And I think, last but not least, if we can have a development or a master plan for the area. I just want to make sure that you will have to make sure that if we will be able to pass this measure, that there was no development, impediment. No, wala po tayong binapayulit na batas. No? Sana ko ay inyo pong maintindihan. But be rest assured that this committee, Committee on Urban Housing and Urban Planning, will be supportive of any measure that will provide housing to our people. Okay, so, again, so this point, suspend this hearing until the submission of these documents, and we'll just inform you of the next hearing. Thank you, gentlemen.